Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Jibedaya Kori.
Hare Krishna, my name is Sarvadrik Das and we're here today making a video presentation for the ISKCON Congregational Development Ministry. And we'd like to say something about the wonderful life and example of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Srila Satchidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Srila Prabhupada said that we are all Bhaktivinoda Parivar. We're all members of the family of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, whose vision it was to spread Krishna Bhakti all over the world. In 1896, he sent one book, Sri Chaitanya, His Life and Precepts, to McGill University in Canada, because his vision was to take Krishna, Lord Chaitanya's movement all over the world. And this also happened to be the birth year of our beloved Srila Prabhupada. 1896, Srila Prabhupada appeared in this world to fulfill the mission of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, to spread Krishna Bhakti all over the world. He appeared in this world in 1838, September 2nd, in the family of Bengali Vaishnavas. His name was Kedaranath Datta, or affectionately known as Kane Datta. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur preached by his sterling example. He wasn't just a philosopher, rather he lived what he preached. He was a government minister in the British Raj, a very responsible government minister in the British Raj, responsible for not only the court system, but for all the inner workings of the Jagannath Puri Temple, where hundreds of thousands of people come every day. That was also his responsibility. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur had 13 children, but we think it's difficult to raise one or two kids. Can you imagine? 13 children. His wife was also Srimati Bhagavati Devi, was also Param Vaishnavi, pure devotee. And they had a huge family. And everyone was Krishna conscious. Everyone served the Lord. So much so that in the childhood life of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he inadvertently ate one mango meant for offering to the deity when he was like 3 years old. And Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur mildly admonished him that you've taken this fruit, this is meant for the service of the Lord, for the Lord's pleasure. Why have you taken it? Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur mildly rebuked him. But Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, whose whole life wouldn't take mango, even in his 60 years old, his disciples would offer him mango, said, no, I cannot take, I'm an offender. This was the quality of the household life of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Everybody was Krishna conscious. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote 100 books and published innumerable magazine articles, wrote hundreds of beautiful Vaishnav bhajans. Srila Prabhupada was sitting in our Denver, Colorado ISKCON temple on the Vyasasan, and he said that these bhajans by Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur are non-different from the Vedas, non-different from the Vedas, non-different from the Vedas. He said three times for emphasis that these beautiful bhajans by Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur contain the whole essence of Vedic theology in simple Bengali language. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur performed invaluable service to Vaishnav Dharma. At the time, a Vaishnava was considered a completely disreputable person, a beggar, a sycophant, a leech in society, a fallen person. So Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, by his strong preaching, established the respectability of Vaishnava Dharma as it was taught directly by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And he smashed all the deviant Sahajiya groups of the time, the Owls, the Bows, the Gauranga Nagaris, the Saki Bekis, all these different prominent, at the time, Apasampradayas were smashed by the powerful preaching of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, who established the respectability of real Vaishnava Dharma as it was taught, in the Vedas. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur painstakingly researched all ancient historical documents to re-establish the actual place of the birth of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. A deviant group was trying to propose that he was born on the other side of Ganga in Navadvip. But by his meticulous research, he established that the actual birthplace of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was in Mayapur. And having faith in that, he took his guru, Srila Jagannath Das Babaji, to that spot. At the time, Srila Jagannath Das Babaji was 130 years old. He was invalid. He couldn't walk. He had to be carried in a basket. But when they brought him to that place, established, identified by Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Srila Jagannath Das Babaji jumped out of the basket, began chanting, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. The place was covered with tulsi plants, and when they excavated the temple, they found the deity of Lord Vishnu that was worshipped in the house of Jagannath Mishra, Lord Chaitanya's father. This indeed is the actual place of the birth of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, established by the mercy and contribution of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur.